Next, some music and conversation never before seen on television. Music and Stories with Jay Black.
Only in America was a story that I walked into Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller's office, who were the pioneers of rock and roll. I said, that's a great song. They said, you want to do it? I said, what are you kidding? It was done by the Drifters, but it was 1963. And in 1963, it would have been hypocritical for a black group to sing Only in America when there was a civil rights movement and they weren't even allowed to sit in front of a bus. So I did it, and I wasn't happy with it because they sped it up. And I thought they took me off and put on Donald Duck, you know. I was driving to Florida with the group. We didn't have enough money to fly. That's how bad things were. And I remember when we got near Miami, they said, and this week, number one, it was number one in Miami. And I was swaying off the road, almost like a guy texting. Although that word didn't exist in 1963.
We'll always remember him as The Voice. I'm TJ Lubinsky, and here are some of my memories of working with Jay Black.
Pacific when I was a kid, and when I said I wanted to record this song, the record company said, what are you, crazy? You're going to destroy American music. I had one of the biggest hits ever with this song. Rodgers and Hammerstein wrote it. As a matter of fact, one of them died about a month after I recorded it. I don't know if I had anything to do with it. But let's make it really romantic, guys.
Across the crowded room.
A chance meeting in a New York coffee shop and a throwaway studio session made a splash on the charts with one of the group's most festive hits, Nearly.
Come a little bit closer, my good friend Wes Farrell, God rest his soul. He sang it to me in a coffee shop. I went in, they said, hey, they gave me a napkin with the lyrics. They said, just sing for the band, and then you'll come back after your tour and record it. And I sang, did it in one take. Left. I'm coming back from Chicago, and I hear it on the radio. So I call up the radio, I call up the record company and say, I'm going to sue you. What are you, crazy? I never finished it. They said, it's number 48 in the country the third week. I said, disregard the call.
After Border, cut it. And then I want to shift that forward.
After recording one of my TV shows, we often record a soundtrack version. Here's footage of what happens. Never before seen or told.
Should I do it now?
In a little cafe, just the other side of the border. She was sitting there giving me looks that made my mouth water. So I started walking her way. She belonged to Batman Jose. In my new years, I knew I should leave. Then I heard.
Whether in person, on television, or in the studio, Jay Black was always a one-take wonder.
Most of my hits were one. Caramia was one take. They didn't want me to do it. They said, you know, who are you? Alan Jones, Mario Lanza. But I said, I kept telling him, it's destroying the place. Everywhere we go, people are standing. So they put it on the B-side. And then this jockey from Pennsylvania turned it over. And it became history.
The next song I'm going to do for you, I have to explain this before I do it. I recorded this song when I was 25 years old. So bear in mind, I decided that because of the notes in this song, how high they were, that I would retire at the age of 40. Now, circumstances led up to me not being able to retire, so I hit 50. And I said, what am I going to do for the next couple of years? Well, to make a long story short, I'm now 62 years old and have to hit the same notes. But as you can see by the color of my hair and by my body, nobody here will say, why doesn't he quit? You're just going to look at me if I hit a bad note and say, what a pity.
Jay's voice throughout the years gave us many magic moments.
Magic Moment was a tribute. That was a tribute, our tribute album. We did a tribute to the Drifters. We just happened to sell a couple of million records, more than theirs.
This magic moment. So different than, so new and like any other. Until I kissed you, and then it happened.
Jay's voice throughout the years gave us many magic moments.
Magic Moment was a tribute. That was a tribute, our tribute album. We did a tribute to the Drifters. We just happened to sell a couple of million records, more than theirs.
This magic moment, so different than, so new and like any other, until I kissed you, and then it happened, it took me by.
Plus with Prime, I'm in.
Claritin knocks out symptoms from over 200 allergens without knocking you out. Live Claritin Clear.
With his recent sad passing, we're all reminded that time is short. The sad reality of where we are today with the music, a sentiment that Jay, reflecting on his audience, never took for granted.
I realize what this means because I did this show years and years ago, and the emails and letters continue to come in. And some of them are so emotional to me that I can actually cry. And, you know, somebody coming over to me and saying, you got a great voice. That's nice. Thank you. But somebody telling me that I helped them or touched them, or I was in a foxhole in Vietnam and you kept me alive, things like that. Those are things that are important to me. Or I have a serious disease and I come to see you and I feel better. Those are things that are important to me.